two states have delayed implementation of work requirements in their Medicaid programs. We're talking about Arizona and Indiana, two states that both had work requirements in Medicaid scheduled to take effect January 1st of 2020. Let's talk about Arizona first and then move on to Indiana. Arizona delayed implementation of their work requirements, and the announcement came in just three sentences at the top of their website. And this is the website that's on the Arizona Healthcare Cost Containment Systems page, the AHCCCS website. And the statement largely just said that while they remain committed to implementing the community engagement waiver, as which they're calling their work requirements, granted by CMS, reminding us that the feds have approved work requirements in Medicaid for them, and while they hoped for a January 1st start date, they are delaying that implementation due to court cases in other states. Their plan has largely been called the most aggressive in the country. They had a very strict work requirement that was set to be implemented that would have required about 120,000 individuals in Arizona to work or lose their Medicaid. That was one of the most strict in the entire country. Let's now turn and look at Indiana. Indiana's Family and Social Services Administration, the FSSA, issued a press release on Halloween that says that they're going to suspend what they called their Gateway to Work program and other Medicaid changes that were proposed. And they said the reason was, again, to allow lawsuits to be resolved. And they were talking about lawsuits both in the state of Indiana and in other states like Kentucky and Arkansas and New Hampshire. They want to let those lawsuits be resolved. And again, they were on track to be implemented January 1st, and that now will be delayed. Now, a quick shout out to Indiana's other Medicaid changes. They, in their waiver, had requested permission and were granted changes like adding premiums to their Medicaid program, having lockout penalties for people that don't pay, eliminating retroactive coverage, that's that backdating of eligibility for people had they applied earlier and been deemed eligible earlier, could have used the service. A lot of states have backdated eligibility. Indiana wanted to get rid of that. They also wanted to get rid of non-emergency medical transportation. That is the Medicaid benefit that pays for your ride to your doctor's appointment. So Indiana wanted to cut back on a lot of services, add premiums to the services, and add work to their Medicaid program. Now, that is also in litigation, and right now those changes aren't in full set to be implemented. Why are we bringing you updates on Indiana and Arizona? It's mostly because this is part of a new pattern. A lot of states had wanted work requirements in their Medicaid program, about 20 states. A lot of those now are in litigation, like we mentioned, Arkansas, Kentucky, New Hampshire, and now with the pauses in Indiana and Arizona, likely because of that litigation, they want to see what the courts will do before they start kicking up to 120,000 people off of the Medicaid program, as is the case in Arizona. We mention it from being from the state of Wisconsin. Wisconsin is slowly implementing its own waiver that adds things like premiums to its Badger Care Plus program, which is a subset of Medicaid that adds co-pays for using the emergency room, has a work requirement that's scheduled to be implemented, but isn't yet on a timeline to go into effect. So we in Wisconsin are watching this very closely as well. Now, there are various stages of litigation for these work requirement states, but we want to bring your attention back to Indiana right before we let you go to remind you that that's the state where Seema Verma is from. This is the CMS, Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services Administrator. She runs the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services. She was the consultant that suggested that work requirements in Indiana was a good idea. This is her idea, and she's one of the people tasked with approving work requirements for other states, and she's been very generous in doing so. Now the courts have a chance to weigh in and say, wait, is this really in the best interest of a state's Medicaid program? Is it furthering the objectives of Medicaid, and is it furthering the health of the people of that state? And courts overwhelmingly so far have said, no, it's not. And there's substantial research now that has found that Medicaid work requirements just don't work. They are ineffective at promoting employment. They don't actually help people get jobs, and they certainly don't help reduce poverty. We've got a lot of links in the description below where you can read some of these announcements first coming out of Arizona, those three sentences that say we're not going to do this right now. You can read that Indiana press release that came out on Halloween, and you can also look at some of that body of research that points towards why Medicaid work requirements just don't work. Make sure you subscribe since this is an ongoing process. Subscribe to stay up to date on what happens next with work requirements in Medicaid.
We'll be right back.